Most of my books that I have here are non-fiction books, because that's probably what I read the most, but I definitely also have a few fiction books thrown in there. This is an example of a fiction book. I love this book so much, and I also love the movie being there. That's great. I've got Immanuel Kant's Critique of Practical yes. Guns, Germs, and Steel. Ann Phillips here, Engendering Democracy. She is a feminist political philosopher. And, yeah, good stuff. This is another one from my Jewish philosophy class. Dan Brown's A Lost Symbol, which is awesome. I love Dan Brown. I love The Da Vinci Code, and I love The Lost Symbol, too, I gotta say. This is a collection of essays, which this is a textbook that I had for a women's studies course that I took in my last semester of university. Okay, let's see. Ideas of the Great Philosophers. You know, this book has actually been floating around my house for a very, very, very long time, like before I even got interested. Of motherhood between France and America, and it's super interesting. I was sitting at a cafe once, and this woman, the waitress actually came up to me because she saw that I had this book, and she was like, "Oh my gosh, are you gonna do the you know, the French parenting style they talk about in this book?" And I at that point I was only like a third of the way through. Yourself in the world, fantastic book for beginners looking into connecting their spirituality with their personal power, I would say. Monet, we've got, yeah, just a book of his works. The Red Tent. Interesting. He wrote Hume. This is a textbook from, I think, one of the courses that I took. What was it called? It was called, I think this was for my metaphysics class. I don't know. Okay, let's see. The Science, When Science Meets Religion. That was another book I had for a, I think there's still this was definitely for one of my anthropology courses. And then we have, of course, Lolita by Vladimir Nabokov, and, you know, controversial. That one I just read on my own. Birth Ambassadors. So, when my sister got pregnant, like, 3 or 4 years ago, I got very interested. Types of births and preparation. This in particular talks about doulas, which are birth assistants, and but doulas are not medical professionals. They're emotional, physical, spiritual ambassadors. Hypnobirthing, the Mongan method. That's another birthing techniques book. I got Call Me By Your Name after I saw the film. I was like, I have to read the book. So that's the book by Andre Aziman. And it's every bit as wonderful as I had hoped. Yeah. These are actually two books right here that I still have from high school, if you can believe it. This was a book that I had to get for my AP literature course, and this one was for an English course I think I took like junior year. The Boys and Women Bible, also by Barbara Kingsolver. This book is incredible. Seriously, it was so good that I kept it forever. This right here is amazing. The Time Falling Bodies Take to Light. This is awesome by William Irvin Thompson. Mythology, Sexuality, and the Origins of Culture. This is seriously amazing book. Amazing, amazing, amazing. I highly recommend. Outlander. Okay, so this was actually given to me by an old roommate, and I really wasn't into Outlander at that time. I think that was right when Connor, I think. Let's see. And he's a professor, an anthropology professor at Emory University. Oh, it's upside down. And he's talking about, in this book, he was on NPR and talking about women as the superior in moving forward is a, as the sex that's better suited to the future that we're facing, and he talks about, you know, evolution of sex and biology and everything, and, yeah, Stream investigative journalist. He wrote applying heat to the food, which spurred our development. So yeah, this book is awesome. Like, I definitely think that when we look back at the way that psychedelics were stigmatized and not made available to people who have been struggling with traumatic events and PTSD and all that, and lots of just chronic conditions and chronic pain, I think we're gonna kick ourselves. I know that there was, you know, it's, I think with psychedelics, like, it's good to treat those substances respectfully, you know. They shouldn't be abused, and they should be treated for what they are, which is an incredibly powerful tool. Very depressing book, but it's also honestly so funny. Like, his humor, it's dark humor, obviously, because he's talking about death and suffering and how it's better to not have been born than to, you know, live the life that humans are destined to live on Earth, full of suffering. And but it's honestly, like, he's such a good writer, and it made me laugh. This book made me laugh so much. Like, let's look at this, for example. We forgive only madmen and children for being free with us. a big one. Journey Tibetan Book of Living and Dying. Fantastic. This was by Sol Gellring Boucher. And oh wow, like I gotta be honest, the first time I ever heard of like the Book of the Dead or the Book of the Living and the Dying was actually in that movie. What is it called? Enter the things, but I hadn't heard of that, of, you know, the Eastern explanation of, like, what happens when you die, and, like, as you die, and, like, the way that you lose your senses one by one, and it tells you, like, the order, and the things that you start seeing, and, yeah, super interesting, kind of scary, but also not scary, because, you know, to expect. I've read the foreword so far, but I can't wait to read the rest of it. The Immortality Key. Okay. Next. Anthropology of Religion. Oh, another textbook I used for tells you what the social and actually business protocol. So it tells you the social faux pas to avoid and the how each different culture treats punctuality, for example, or gift giving, and just what to expect when you're doing business in another country. But it's also good for people who are traveling to different countries and you want to know, sort of the cultural orientation and like what's appropriate or not appropriate. It This one has like this has plant substitutes for all of those things, which is awesome. And it also gives like a history of witchcraft and a history of magic that is very, very well written. And, you know, it gives that ancient context to all the modern practices that you see. And, you know, talks about how magicians and people who knew about the stars very well respected figures in society and were very often close with political leaders of their time. Okay, I do have some more that were on my bedside table. This is Women Who Run With the Wolves by Dr. Clarissa Pinkola Estes. And this is amazing. It's like all the mythologies of the wild woman archetype throughout the world. It's incredible. Within every woman, there lives a powerful force filled with good instincts, passionate creativity, and ageless knowing. She is the wild woman, the woman who represents the instinctual nature of women. But she is an endangered species. In Women Who Run with the Wolves, Dr. Estes unfolds rich intercultural myths, fairy tales, and stories, many from her own family. A lot. nutrition, animal ethics, amazing. This is the feminist approach, the feminist philosophy behind animal ethics. I've actually, this is a collection of essays, and I haven't read all of them, but I've read a few of them because I've been really trying to come to terms ethically with meat eating, veganism, all of that, and I really just wanted to educate myself more. Animal ethics was part of a philosophy class that I took, but it wasn't the focus of it. And so this one I just got on my own so that I could read up a bit. This is actually going to be such a long video because I forgot about this other stack of books over here and the other bookshelf I have, which I'll show you. Okay, so this is mainly astrology books now that I'm going to be showing you. Right there. Okay, sextrology. Sexual compatibility of the signs. Great reference book. This is by Starsky and Cox, which are also the authors of this book, Cosmic Coupling. This is more like snapshots of the relationship, whereas, of like specific combinations, whereas this goes into, you know, the deeper carnality of each sign as well as their combination. Okay, these two books right here. First, and wait, no, this one was first, I think. Yeah, this one is his first book, and beautiful writer. I highly recommend both of these books if you're looking, looking to incorporate a kind of spiritual element into your environmental ethic. These two books, definitely great. Okay, Philosophy of Science. This was my textbook for my philosophy of science course. Honestly, not my favorite, I gotta say. If I'm being totally honest, I found that class pretty boring at the time. I think if I took it now, I'd be way more into it, but at the time, oh my god, I couldn't stand it. Okay, more astrology books. Linda Goodman's Love Signs. So if you know who Linda Goodman is, you know that she is a very famous astrologer, I think from the 80s, I want to say. And she's like the classic go-to for so many astrologers today. Like, she really popularized a lot of astrological literature back in the day. So this is Love Signs. So, like, you know, the love compatibilities and love styles of the different signs. Sign and, you know, doing the personality analysis of each one, not necessarily doing compatibility, but really going into, you know, the temperament of, you know, a Capricorn boss, or let's say you have a child that's an Aquarius, you know, as she goes in that sort of, context. And, she is a very funny writer. She incorporates a lot of, like, just these really hilarious tangents in her writing that really illustrate the point she's making, like, really well. Okay, so I've brought you to my other bookshelf. You've probably seen this bookshelf sitting behind me in a few of my other videos, but here it is. This bookshelf is mainly comprised of, like, my really, like, esoteric reference books. Not all of them, obviously. Like, Homo Deus is not an esoteric reference book. This is the sequel to, what is it? Sapiens by Yuval Noah Harari. You know, I don't really like this book. Like, I find it, I just think, Awakening. Just a classic. I would say that if you're starting to read Joseph Campbell or get into comparative mythology, this is the first book you have to read. It's amazing. Like, I feel like every person who reads this book is just so, ends up being so heavily influenced by it. It's great.
Yeah.
book that I definitely should, I need to get into.